Victor's Assembly Church is located along River Road at former Casino Cinema near Kenya Uniform Distributors. To give your offering, send through our M-Pesa number
7:1-9:1-8. Another day. So ask your neighbor for me, do you believe? Tell them for me, every wall of unbelief, of doubt, and impossibility around your mind, lazima iporomoke leo. Tafuta mwingine muulize, ngoja, mwambie nani alikuambia haitawezekana. Mwambie alikudanganya. We are in a possibility service. And I sense a shift in the atmosphere. Come on, give him praise. Those who are watching us online, Wednesday atupendi maneno, sisi tunapenda kupambana. It is a rescue service. So this is for those people who need their urgent case to be heard. This is a service where those people who have desires come to God, and the God who answers by fire answers very quickly. So do I have such people in the house that are saying enough is enough? Lift your hand and say, every wall of impossibility that is standing before me, in the name of Jesus, you must come down. You must come down. You must come down. You must come down. In Jesus' name do we pray. Esther chapter 4 and verse 14. We are what we are dealing with is that every evil verdict, and a verdict may be a decision, may be a judgment, may be a determination, may be a conclusion, may be an opinion, may be the end result. Whatever it is, the verdict of the enemy concerning your life, today it must expire. Kazi yao ni kuamua, lakini kazi yetu ni kupindua amri zao. I can't hear your amen. Amen. Esther 4:14. But for if, let's all read together, one to go. Tell your neighbor, for if you remain completely silent. Hivo umenyamaza. Na inaonekana utaki kuongea. Relief and deliverance will arise from another source. You don't get me. That's why you're not getting excited. But let me tell you. For if you remain completely silent, kuna watu sahi, umepata mambo, you've decided to remain completely silent. In the school of victory and in the school of the supernatural, silence is not a weapon. It is a sign of defeat. Somebody say, I have an opinion concerning my matters. I have the final say in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and say, I am not helpless. I am not. Who is helpless and I am not? Relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another source. The Jews may be your family. The Jews may be your business. The Jews may be your career. Whatever stands for the Jews, help is available. Amen. One thing that is guaranteed is that help is there. It is only the source that will change. Marvin Bado, niko hapa sijui kama niko pale. Tell me, but God has guaranteed you that help is available, even if it's from another source. Concerning your help, it is not negotiable. Lift up your voice and say, any man or woman assigned by God to help me, but they have refused. Oh God, release help from another source. Release help from another source. Release help from another source. Oh God, release help from another source. I can hear you. In Jesus' name do we pray. Tell your neighbor, you either fight or perish. There is no middle ground. And then Esther was told, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet, who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this. It means that where you're standing and where you're seated, you are not just there to fill an empty chair. You carry deliverance for somebody. And in case you decide not to help those you ought to help, the truth is, God will release help from another source, but you will not be a partaker of it. Somebody say, I refuse to sign out of divine help because of ignorance or laziness. Oh God, empower me to fight. Empower me to fight. Empower me to fight. Empower me to fight. Take a minute and pray to him. Oh Lord, empower me to fight. Empower me. I can hear you. If you don't help whoever you are supposed to help, help will come from another source. Zeba na 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 na. Tainua macho yangu, nitazame milimani. Sada wangu watoka wapi? Ninajua kwako Yesu. Nitainua macho yangu, nitazame milimani. Sada wangu watoka wapi? Ninajua kwako Yesu. Wewe Yesu,
Yesu wangu,
umeiponya to understand that verdicts come from three sources. Somebody say God. God gives verdicts. When you talk about verdicts, conclusions, opinions, determination, final say, or judgment, all those are verdicts. And in Jonah chapter 3 and verse 10, the Bible says, then God saw their works, that they turned from their evil way, and God relented from the disaster, and that he had said he would bring upon them, and he did not do it. God changes his mind concerning the judgments over your life. Tell me about any judgment from God in your life today. It shall be overturned. If God himself overturns and changes verdicts, who is man to remain the same? God is the only one who is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. And concerning Jonah, the Bible says that when God saw the works of the people of Nineveh, when he saw that they had repented and come with ashes, he relented, he repented, he turned back, and he said, I will not do that which I had purposed to do. Today we are appealing to God. Even if it is you that is judging me, oh God, change your mind. Change your mind. When you know that God is on your side, if God be for us, who can be against us? Make sure for 1 minute God is on your side. Lord, even if my condition, it is as a result of judgment from you, I appeal for mercy today. 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 You can just open up your mouth and pray to your Father. Make sure you are at peace with God. Lord, even if the judgment in my life is from you. In Jesus' name do we pray. Luke 22 and verse 31. Judgments can also come from Satan. Luke chapter 22 and verse 31. Oh, Simon, Simon. Luke 22 verse 31. It says, Simon, Simon, Satan has asked to sift you like wheat. Oh, Jehovah God, tell your neighbor, Satan may have vowed to sift you like wheat. Kuna watu sahi wako kwa kisiagi ya shetani. Anangojea tu ma. Ambia jirani yako hata kama umewekelewa kwa kisiagi. Uko karibu kusiagwa umalize. That judgment can be reversed. And the Lord said, it is not Satan that was saying, it is God himself. God acknowledging that Satan also has verdicts concerning us. Satan has already made decisions concerning your future. He has already made decisions about your marriage, about your career, about your looks, about your future, about your money, about your husband, about your wife, about how your family should look like. And you already know the determination of Satan is not good towards you. Si tunalewa hiyo? And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, when you hear the Lord called you twice, no, Satan is serious. Tell neighbor, concerning your case, Satan is not joking. He is looking at the end product, which is unga, unga. Mwambie ni unga, naona chapo. Satani akikuangalia akuoni ati ukiwa naite. Satani anakuona ukiwa 6 feet under. Because that is his ministry. To kill, to see. Satan does not see you at one time having a bank account. He sees you broke. Not even begging. Damp. Where you don't even have a mouth to beg. So those of you who are supporters of Satan, I bring to you that his verdict to you is the end product. Kuna watu wengine wanatetea shetani, mnamuingilia sana, mnapiga sana. Who made you a bedfellow? Satan has no friends. Even when you quote him, he has no ability to be a friend. He's a betrayer to the minimum. Hata ukichinjia shetani nguruwe, ama umchinjie nini, shetani hata achana na wewe. Because his nature is to steal, to kill. And then he said, indeed, Simon, Simon, indeed. Now see, it's not your uncle saying, it's Jesus telling Simon. Simon, Simon, indeed, surely, surely, Satan has asked for you. Shetani anakuulizi? Ambia jirani yako, shetani anakuulizi. Ili akusiage kama gano. Verse 32. But I have prayed for you that your faith. So what is it that gives you power not to be like wheat, to be sifted like wheat? The power of your faith. The power of your faith. Lift up your hands and say, every demonic attack against my faith. Expire in the name of Jesus. Expire in the name of Jesus. Radebo satara baka da 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 bo sebeke. Da 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 da. In Jesus' name do we pray. So Satan wants to sift you as wheat. So who is the swifter? Who is the sifter? Kisiagi ni nani? Ambia jirani yako, watu ni kisiagi. Satan is looking for the end product, but he has already made a judgment and has given assignment to people to make sure that by the time you return to church, you will be minced meat. He said, but I prayed for you that your faith should, that when you have returned to me, it means that he was to go for a while. Hello? Ilikuwa aende for a while. Then akirudia Yesu, he was saying, when you return to me, when you return, you will be a testimony to brethren. Ragoshata, I pray that you shall become a strength to the weak in the house. Yeyote anatumika kama kisiagi, your faith will not fail. Open up your mouth and say, my father, my father. Strengthen my faith that I may not fail. That I may not fail. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. My Father, strengthen my faith that I may not fail. 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 Faith failure is a disaster in the waiting. Rabbi Gedeborobo Zakada sounding better now. Manderebo Shatarabagada da 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 Pray for yourself that your faith will not fail. That though you are broke, that your faith will not fail. Though you are divorced, that your faith will not fail. Though you are forsaken, but your faith will not fail. In Jesus' name do we pray. Nehemiah chapter 6 and verse 9. Nehemiah chapter 6 it says, for all they were trying to make us afraid, saying, their hands will be weakened in the work, and it will not be done. Now, therefore, O God, strengthen my hand. Tobiah, Sanballat, and the team had decided that even though Nehemiah has a project, it will not be done. I know there is a work you've started. There is a marriage you want to build. There is a home you want to construct. There is education you want to complete. There are children you want to raise. But there is an enemy sitting somewhere saying it cannot be done. Who says and it comes to pass unless the Lord has commanded it? Whoever has said you will not finish, if they have to go down for you to finish, we are arising in warfare. Open up your mouth and say, every assembly of my haters that has made that determination, I will not finish what I started. Hear the word of the Lord. I shall finish. Scatter and fall. Scatter and fall. Every association, every assembly of my haters. I don't like the way you are praying. I wish you can pray better. Assembly of your haters. Manderebo shapa kato pese beke to magadada. Manderebo sebeke tara ba 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 se. Manderebo shapa karabo sebeke re 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 ba shantaria be re be re be re be sa. Re be re ba ra ba shantaria re be re 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 ba. In Jesus' name do we pray. If you have no people who hate you, I know you are going nowhere. The minute you begin going somewhere, suddenly people begin to have interest in you. So I know you are going far by the many forces that have had to gang together to bring you down. But wherever they are gathered together against you, they shall fall for your sake. I can't hear your amen. So what is the purpose of evil verdicts? Number one, to create walls around you. When they make a verdict, for instance, if you go and somebody is stalking you, and you go to the courts and say, all I want is A and B. Let them be given a restraining order for them not to come near me. There are some demons who will restrain. The demon and the smell of poverty will never come to you. I can't hear your amen. There are some diseases and some spirits we are going to put a wall around. They will not come near us in the name of Jesus. I came to declare the verdicts of God can be changed. The verdicts of man can be changed. The verdicts of Satan can be changed. And no power can stop you. Open up your voice and say, every demonic restraining order issued against my prosperity, issued against my money. Hold on. How do you know there is a restraining order against your money? There is a level of financial success you cannot attain. The minute you reach 100,000, it is like you have broken State House or you have broken the bank. It is like all hell break loose. That tells you there is a restraining order. But wherever God wants you to occupy, you will occupy. Jesus said, occupy till I come. Wherever the soles of your feet shall tread upon, you shall possess a possession. We are not negotiating. Even if it was a verdict by your grandfather, even if it was a verdict by the village witchcraft, even if it's a verdict by the agriculture, all verdicts can be overruled. I can't hear you. Amen. Open up your mouth and say, every restraining order prohibiting me from enjoying financial breakthrough. Enough is enough. Scatter in the name of Jesus. All demonic law enforcement agencies that have declared that will not move to the next level. You are a liar. Shandere barabarabazai. Mandere barabashandere barabarabazai. Ribarabashantari abere barabashandere barabarabe. Begin to declare whatever they say that will not enter, whatever they say that will not happen. I remove your limitation in the name of Jesus. I remove your limitation in the name of Jesus. I remove your limitation in the name of Jesus. In the demonic camp, in the demonic limitation, placed upon my finances, right now be removed in the name of Jesus. I shall have what I need to have. I shall occupy where I need to occupy. I shall possess what I need to possess. Every demonic restraining order against my finances, enough is enough. In the name of Jesus, Satan, you're a loser. Satan, you're a loser. Satan, you're a liar. In the name of Jesus, Rechabakatoshati, Rajabashemakatuka. Now begin to erase every invisible line. Every invisible line that you say that will never cross. I'm crossing in the name of Jesus. That line you say that will never cross. 100,000 line, 1,000,000 line, 10,000,000 line, 100,000,000 line, 1,000,000,000 line. Evil lies drawn against me that I will never cross. I remove your restraining order. I remove your restraining order. Open your mouth like a warrior. Every place that I've been told I will never step in. Any country that there is an injunction against me. Any nation that they say that I will never preach. I remove your restraining order. I remove your restraining order. Wherever the soles of my feet shall tread upon, I will take as a possession. I want you to remove your shoes. And as you stand on this altar, begin to declare any evil lies drawn against my feet that I will never enter, that I will never possess. I destroy evil lies. I destroy evil lies. Every evil restriction, any evil line, any restraining order placed upon my feet, I remove it in the name of Jesus. My feet shall enter into greatness. My feet shall possess my own territory. Whatever say that you will never own land, your feet shall possess. Whoever said you will never stay in a home, you will be a vagabond. In the name of Jesus, I shall be an established wife. I shall be an established mother. I shall be an established businesswoman. Any power that wants me to remain a wanderer, you are a liar. My seed shall settle down. I shall settle down in the house of God. I shall settle down in my territory. I shall settle down in the land the Lord shall give me. Any vagabond cast, any limitation on my feet, be removed in the name of Jesus. I roar like a lion. They shall not restrain your feet. I want a kuizuia kuingia. They live only plus men. What is really a kuingia into prosperity? But they say if we go, we die, let us die. But we will not be prevented. Any power that prevented my grandmother, any power that prevented my father, any power that prevented my mother from entering into her place of destiny, any power that prevented my grandfather and realize against him, that is why he never prospered. In the name of Jesus, I take power and authority over all evil lines that are drawn against my prosperity. In the name of Jesus, I cross the line. I cross the line. I cross the line. I go beyond the restriction. I go beyond the restriction. Mahali walisema hakuna tena university, my children shall cross over. Mahali walisema ndoa zitakaa, I cross over. Mahali walisema watajenga lakini hawataishi, I cross over. Mahali walisema hakutakuwa mzee katika boma yetu, I cross over. I like the warring spirit in the house. Mahali walisema miguu yako haitaingia, ya kwamba utazurura hii Kenya na utapata mahali utaita kwako. Utazurura hii Kenya lakini utapata mahali utaita kwako. The devil is a liar. Resetere magadadadadadadadadade irabazabagadarabasantariabede Rata bagaza bagada. Let every wall around me be broken. Let every restriction be removed. Let every limitation be removed. Let every restriction be removed. Raba baba bashataria bigita. Seketai anderebo shataria debaga. Baba, now begin to pray in the power. Try to control my progress. You are a liar. Release my progress. As I enter into the month of July, I shall move faster. I shall progress. Because evil bodies are meant to control progress. Are meant to control growth. Are meant to control movement. Any verdict, any resolution, any conclusion, any determination by men or by demons to hinder my progress, to control my growth, to control my size, to control my width. Hear the word of the Lord. I shall break forth on the right and on the left. I shall break through in the north. I shall break in the east. I shall break in the north, in the west and in the south. I shall break forth. The north shall accept me. The east shall accept me. The west shall accept me. The south shall accept me. The center shall accept me. Any restriction. Arabo Satayana Rabagadane. Any power trying to control your growth. Unajaribu kuinua biashara hainuki. Unashindwa ni nini haufanyi. There is an evil decision. Kuna an evil verdict against you. Ambayo ilisema utawai endelea. Waliungana wakasema utawai za. Waliungana wakasema utawai endesha gari. Lakini in the name of Jesus, we remove the akoti rabagazaya. Oriata rabagadara rabashata. Walishikana mikono wakifunga na kuomba. Wakasema utawai onekana. Walienda kwa waganga wakasema hata ukijaribu hautafaulu. But who says that it comes to pass unless the Lord has commanded it? Mahali waliketi wakaelewana ya kwamba nyuma ya mama yangu hakuna atakayeendelea. Mapatano yao ninayamaliza, makubaliano yao ninayatawanya. In the name of Jesus, itarabagadadadadadia shiribigidididia. They are controlling, remote controlling your growth. Ndio maana umekaa kwa cheo moja muda mrefu. Ndio maana unachangaa pesa zako zinafanya nini. Ndio maana unashangaa kwa nini mtu hakuna mtu anaendelea. Waliketi wakashikana mikono na wakaelewana, as long as wanaishi hautawai songa mbele. Umejaribu kujenga umeshindwa. Umejaribu kujiendeleza umeshindwa. Lakini mapatano yao lazima ya sabaratike. Mahali waliingia kuzimo, wakaingia mikataba na mizimo, wakaingia mikataba na waliokufa, wakaingia kwa mikataba ya mbuzi, wakaingia mikataba ya tohara, mikataba yote ya tohara. Wakasema utawai faulu katika jina la Yesu. Wacha mikataba yao isabaratike. Ay, 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 ay Jesus' name do we pray. The purpose and the will of God for your life is effortless victory, effortless progress, effortless growth. But anytime there's an evil verdict, an evil decision, an evil determination, an opinion about you, what they do is that the wicked can be brought together because of their determination to bring one righteous man. But the Bible says they shall gather together, but not by me. And wherever they are gathered against you, they shall scatter seven directions. So anytime you notice your growth is controlled or manipulated, you cannot give an explanation why you're not growing. Most likely, there are some people behind the scene that have made a conclusion that you do not know. And they are controlling and manipulating your life. I received a testimony from one of us today. And she told me that one person that had employed her was very jealous because of how probably customers valued her. She was the most valuable worker. And so she told God, I don't want to resign from this place. Let this man be the one to make me, to sack me. And after he was sacked, God had already made a way for her to get a loan. And she started a business. In a very busy area, it's unlikely that you get an empty shop. But she got an empty shop. After she got an empty shop, that is not the end of the story. The man used to come to her shop every day and curse her. And tell her, utajua mimi, ninatoka mahali uganga na uchawi inafanya kazi. Your business will never move forward. And today she came to give me a testimony that God has not only fought for her, that but the same shop that she was working in, she has bought the shop. You may not understand, because this is somebody that has slept on the streets because of lack. This is somebody that has endured pain. But I came to tell you, whoever has put a restriction on your growth, they will go down that you may rise. And I'm not talking about because you're in a process or a phase of trials and tribulations. I'm talking of people that have already tasted the goodness of God, but they cannot explain how it was cut off. Most of the times, there are people behind the closet saying, asiendele, asiendele, vire anaenda, they will rule over us. Like the brothers of Joseph, they said, we cannot let him shine. He will rule over us. There could be people that they saw the potential that you have, and they have behind the scene declared, you will never move forward. Will you allow them? No, I know you are very generous. You want them to move forward, that you may remain humble. I ask your neighbor, are you going to allow them? Are you sure? Some of you, the way you are gentlemen and gentle ladies, that is why your enemies know their power is in their numbers. But for believers, you will die alone in church. Saying, najua mungu wangu atakuja. Kuna wakati wa mungu wangu na mungu wetu. Ambia jirani yako, kuna wakati wa mungu wangu na mungu wetu. Kikiumana kabisa, alikuwa anasema, wewe mungu wa Ibrahimu, mungu wa Isaka, do we need godly reinforcement to bring them down? That is why coming to church is not a leisure. It is a coming together of like-minded people. Where their assembly cannot equal our assembly. Because their assembly is done in darkness, ours is done in broad daylight, and has no limitation in attendance. I can't hear your celebration. By this association, I declare, wherever they are gathered in darkness against you, they shall scatter and never see each other again. I can't hear your amen. Whoever has said you will never move forward, let them go down that you may move forward. Shout three amen if you believe it. Amen. So lift up your hands and your voice, and I want you to say, every evil agreement between the enemies of my progress, by the agreement in this house, let your agreement lose power. Shout the second time, let your agreement lose power. Three, celebrate Jesus above your head. In Jesus' name we pray. So evil verdicts create walls. And evil verdicts, what do? They employ the strategy of controlling growth and progress. Number three, they take away rights. Tell me, but anytime there is a verdict in a court of law, rights are taken away or rights are given. Siju kama tunaelewana. Ukienda kotini, koti, when the court rules, there is somebody who will go home happy. there's another one who will go home sad. It's almost impossible when you go to a court, you find everybody happy. That's why the Bible says, before you go to court, elewana na jirani yako kabla. Yeah, that's why the Bible says, before you take your neighbor to court, elewaneni kabla. Because when you go to the court, somebody will go home crying, or both of you. Hallelujah in the house. So you are going to command. You have a right in the word of God to prosper. Somebody say, I have a right to prosper. So if you are not prospering, who has taken away your right? You have a right to be happy in this kingdom. Who has taken your joy? You have a right to be healthy. I wish above all things that you may be. Even as your soul. It is the will of God for you to be saved and delivered out of every situation. It is the will of God that when you look around, your children shall be ornaments of grace. It is the will of God that your wife shall be a fruitful garden. Who took away your rights? Who took away your rights? Ask your neighbor, who took away your rights? Ni nani? Naeza kuwa ni nyanya, naeza kuwa ni baba, babu, ama hata we mwenyewe. Naeza kana ni koti. Like for instance, when they took the rights away from us, from walking in darkness the way we want, even if you are brave, after 10, patikana ije. Abigail has told me several times, nimeshikwa. Amelala kwa kafyu huyu. With all my anointing, I can't deliver her. Why? Because her rights to freedom have been taken away. So for you to be set free, what happens? Somebody has to intervene on your behalf. Either you must have a lawyer. Lawyer. Let me call my lawyer. If it's not a lawyer, you need to have a big brother. You don't need to look other here. We have a big brother called Jesus. He has already won the race for us. You do not need to be known here on earth. When your name is known in heaven, you can appeal to any court and they will hear you. I can't hear your amen. I can't hear your amen. So some of you, you are right to just having nice hair was taken away. I remember one time we were in a service and I said, somebody, God is touching your hair. Your hair will grow again. In one month, they came with a testimony. Their hair has grown. Kuna babepo inajua, ule atakuoa, ni nywele tu ataona. So because they cannot kill you, anakufanya kiparagoto. The devil is a liar. Amen. There is nothing too serious about these things. Tell your neighbor, smiling is not a crime. Don't look like you're the one saving Kenya. Hallelujah in the house. There are some of you, remember Jacqueline, Steve, I am double sure you not have loved her and married her the way you did. It was in a service like this one. I prayed for people with acne, and her acne dried up. So some of the little things that you think are small, they are your rights that have been taken away. And anytime rights are taken away, Satan is looking for a greater gain. Eh? Yo uzembe unakuwaga nayo. Umesikia uzembe. Hata kujaribu kuja kanisa. Ulijivuruta hapa. Your right to come to the house of God, it is because the enemy knows that when you come to the house of God, you'll be loaded with benefits. So anakuload ukiwa huko inje, ndio usifike hapa. Ambia jirani yako, kila mizigo umewekwa na shetani. Na ulikuja hapa. Na kuamuru katika jina la Yesu. Weka mizigo yako chini. Hey, wacha kujifanyaka kama ndio una. You're not the only one living life. Eh? Hata venye unakaa. You're not the only one living life. Enjoy life, oh. Remember, enjoy life, oh. If you are waiting for a man to come and make you happy or a woman to make you wait forever. Joy does not come from people. It comes from within. Now, if you are uncomfortable living on your own at that, what will you do if you have to wait by up to 40? Utajioa? Eh? Situonge tukweli. Si ungoje happily. Sasa wavanya unaka. Ata the way you look, no man can come to you. You already look retired. Bana sve. Bana liwacha kustuka. Sini ukweli. Sinaonaga hivyo. Hata venye unatembeaga unasema nichukue mwenye anataka tu nichukue. Nichukueni, nichukueni. By the time they look at you, nobody wants a hopeless, helpless, low esteem girl. They want people that are minching life with joy and gladness. And if they don't marry me, I am betrothed to the Most High. But it is easier said than done. Minister Alice, I dread for the senior youth. The minute you hear senior, meeting yao hata hainaga breakthrough. Because wanakanga Mungu wako na deni yangu. Ndehera mudo. Mungu wana deni yako. Organize your life. Tell anybody, organize your life. Like nobody is coming to help you. Organize your life. Organize your life. Like nobody is coming. Na kama utakadha at 8 years. Maude, the man who stayed at the pool. Do you think you are more righteous than him? Yeah, he was Jewish. Where you know you are tribe-based, nowhere even in the 9 tribes of Gikuyu. Tell everybody, you choose to be happy. Unafurahingi tu ukikuja hapa. Ukienda sijui, iyo kivazi ya huzuni, unaivaga tu ukitoka hapa. Huko wala karuli mwe, ya unakaa kama simba. Nani atawa simba? You know money follows a currency. Zini kweni? Most likely if you go into a group and you find somebody smiling and with a face that is relaxed, who are you most likely to talk to? Mwenye amekaa hivi. Kama shiradura. Ama mwenye ako relaxed. Some of you, the right to prosperity has been taken away. Ulipewa tu sura ngumu ngumu. Mungu akupatie sura nyororo. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Hebu jifanya hivi, sema hii sura ngumu. Ambayo ina entertain umaskini. Na kuamuru kutoka siku ya leo. Niondoke. Hata watu ukienda kuomba pesa wanakutreat kama suspect. Huyu anapeleka kwa waganga huyu. Na si ati uko mbaya, ni sura ngumu ngumu tu. Especially if you are a girl. You are a woman. Mama ni sura. Sura relaxed. Yes. Who stole your giggle? Ile tulikuwa tunacheka tukiwa 14 years. Tulikuwa tunacheka. What happened when you reached 25? That person is the one who stole your right to be happy the rest of your life. Aye. Why did you give them the right? Naambiaka ukiacho achi? Lakini usijiachirie. Sasa unajiachiriaga eh. Unashinda ukilia the whole night. And after you wake up, you only have red eyes. Nothing resolved. And a dirty pillow. Then organize your life. Organize your life. Umeingia kila department. Ukiona, you are hooking yourself. Simi naongea ukweli. You are hooking. Umeingia sharing. Hapa sishiki. Intercessory. Kara shoot. Haishiki. Nakuja una tap altar wakati kila mtu amenyamaza. Bado hakuna mtu anaona. Najaribu sanctuary keeping. Najaribu finally praise and worship. But sura inastua. Sababu hata venye unakaa tu unakaa kuhurumiwa. Nobody wants baggage. Bana swimming study. Si mimi naongea ukweli. Mi hata kuna watu wanakuja kuniona hapa, najua hapa niko na kibaru. Kama hiyo siku sina neema. Nakwambia, can you see me next week? Next week but one. So that you solve your own issues. So that ukikuja si. Cry all the crying. Then after you cry, come with all. Who took your right to have self-control? Hata moyo wako kama inakushinda. Ya mwingine utaweza. Na hiyo ni point. Hiyo hata mimi nimesikia nimeongea point. Pastor Moya, hiyo nimeongea point. Hiyo kama roho yako mwenyewe ina shida kuhandle. Who do you think will handle yours? You have been broken heart by yourself 10 times. Hata venye unatembea tu, you look like an example of how God abandons people. So God will not attach his glory there because he knows you are a bad advertisement billboard. So naenda kwa wale happy. Because wakiwa happy, out of the abundance of the heart, they'll say, Gayo, le mwega. Lakini wewe anajua kwako ni mochari. Hata akifanya matendo makuu. Gainyure kile, no. No, no. Ulinipia kanyumba, lakini mlango ulisahau. Hii side wanaelewa vile anasema. Hii side. So yona, Mungu umenipatia guo, lakini. Asheria tiguo. Sinaongea ukweli. Sasa Mungu hata wewe kama ni Mungu in the laws of marketing. Would you trust Jackie? Edraliama. Ukweli. Adam Ariza, that is the joy of the Lord. Even you as a marketer, would you put your product on such a human being? You know the product will die before it enters the market. That's what the Bible says, whoever has much, more will be added. Lakini wewe uko na roho kidogo. Mungu anakupatia tu blessing ya roho kidogo. Najua akikupatia 1,100 utakufa. Utaisha. 10,000 sahi ushikiki. Sema, chantafute huyu mwenye ako na roho kubwa. One thing I will pray that you pray today is that God will give you largeness of heart. Largeness. Largeness. That's what Solomon prayed for. Mama akiwa na largeness of heart, there is no way that marriage will ever go down. A mother with largeness of heart, there is no way her children will walk away and feel unprotected. A person that carries largeness of heart is a magnet to God. So whoever took your rights, they must bring them back. And nobody takes your right without your permission. The reason why you are not happy, you can attribute to someone. Why did you give them the right? Take your rights back. Take your rights back. You have a nice story. Hata nikikwambia, tembea wewe ujue vya madhivili alinifanya. Naleta tissue unapanguza. People have all formulas of crying. Especially if it's a man. If it's a woman, I understand. But if you are a man, God deliver you. Minister Moses, that you come to me crying. You unanistua. Nataka wanaume wanajikaza kama Steve. Kipewa mtoto ubebe, ubebe. Kama wewe ubeba kama gunia. Maisha inaendelea. Lakini kama ni wanaume wengine, hiyo kanisa iko na umama. Na mama anafanya tu bebe watoto, si watoto ni wenu. Ni kweli? Kanisa iko na umama, umama. Ni vile pastor ni msichana, ni mama. Kama ni mwanaume tungefanyishwa mambo ya nguvu. Hakuna press ups tunafanya hapa. So, mothers can only do what is within their power. So are you ready to take your rights back? Are we communicating? Lift up your voice and say, any man or woman that I've surrendered my rights to, that I'm no longer happy. Hear the word of the Lord. From this day, I take back my rights. My rights to be happy. My rights to prosper. My rights to be promoted. My right to live a happy life. In the name of Jesus, I take my rights back. Take your rights back. Take your rights back. There is nothing that people have done to you that cannot be forgiven or released. Take back your rights to be happy. Take back your rights to live a large life. I refuse to put my life on hold. I refuse to put my joy on hold. Whether they salute you or they don't, you have a right to be happy. I take back my right. Now the last prayer, Lord, give me largeness of heart. Lord, give me largeness of heart. Lord, give me a large heart that I can accommodate blessings, that can accommodate people, that can accommodate promotion. Give me a large heart. Say banana na 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 na. Kanifungulia lango. Ha! Sayana rabo satayande bo shabadana. Kere amaguru ine nadera kwa nenyota. Higula maida nyonege dimageke. Kere amaguru ine. maido nyone gidimageke kere omaguru ine nadera kwane nyota igora maido nyone gidimageke kere omaguru ine nadera kwane nyota. Give me largeness of heart. Give me a heart that can accommodate people. A heart that can accommodate wealth. A heart that can accommodate contrary opinions. I pray for largeness of heart. Kire omagoro ine nadera kwane nyota. Igora maido nyone gidimageke. Kire omagoro ine nadera kwane nyota. Lord, open my eyes that I may see the well that is just beside me, that I may not die of thirst. Father, we give you glory. Thank you, Lord. There are many of us, Lord, whose rights have been surrendered to those who hurt us, to those who maltreated us, to those who have no business with the great future you have for us. But today, we ask for largeness of heart, that we may love the unlovable, forgive the unforgivable, and that, Lord, we may be able to accommodate and market you the way you deserve. There are many things that you want to do for us, but your limitation is only us. We pray that God enlarge our capacity, make our hearts larger. If you need to forgive, forgive. If you need to let go, let go. Some of you is an ex that you've never forgiven, an ex-boss, ex-husband, stepmother, mother. And unforgiveness has denied you your right. Forgive. Forgive. Thank you, Lord. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Bwana asifiwe sana. My name is Reverend Ruth Wamoyo on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter, and on YouTube. All you need to do is just go to my page, like and follow me, and to my YouTube channel, I'm Ruth Wamoyo. Just go there and hit the red subscribe button. You will receive the latest music, the sermons, the Gorgeous Woman Show, Divine Encounter, and all the services, even lunch hour services. God bless you as you do that.